Please subscribe my channel for having a proper knowledge in accounts, to fill up the gaps of your misconceptions and to fill up the lacunas of your knowledge, so that you can work out your sums alone without taking help of any private teaching or private tutors.
Students, today's topic is sales day book. When you are starting sales day book, we must know the features of sales day book. Number one, it is one of the subsidiary book under special journal. It is a part of special journal. Number two, here only the credit sales of goods or services are recorded. Then first one, it is the part of special journal. Second one, only the credit sale of goods or services are recorded here. Number three, credit sale of assets or stationary items are not recorded here. This is the important point. Then where these are recorded? Credit sale of assets or stationary items are recorded under journal proper. And number four, for cash sales will not be recorded here. Cash sales will be recorded in the cash book. These will not be recorded here. And number five, since it is a part of journal or books of primary entry, from here the entries are posted to customer's account, or you can say debtor's account. From here, so now we'll prepare our sales day book. Now we'll work out one sales day book to make these points clear. That suppose on 1st January 2020, sold to Mr. X goods, means here is given 100 tea bags at the rate of rupees 500 each. 100 tea bags at the rate of rupees 500 each. This means gross amount will be 50,000, and if invoice number is given, that will be written here, and gross amount is 50,000, and trade discount is allowed 10% less trade discount 10%. Therefore 5,000 will come under this column, and net amount will be 45,000, and here trade discount 10% in the remarks column we can write. This is number one. And number two, suppose on 10th January 2020, sold to Mr. Y 50 bags of dusty Mr. Y 50 bags of dust tea at the rate of rupees 300 each. Therefore 50 into 300, that is 15,000 will come here under gross amount, and here trade discount is given 5%. Therefore 750 rupees is trade discount, and net amount will be 15,000 minus 750, that is 14,250. And here also trade discount 5% we should write. This is the second one. And third one, on 29th January 2020, suppose sold to Mr. Z, 200 tins of mustard oil, 200 tins of oil at the rate of rupees 100 each, at the rate of rupees 100 each. That is gross amount will be 20,000. And trade discount is 10% less trade discount 10%. Therefore, 2000 is trade discount here and sales tax is 5%. Therefore, plus sales tax 5% will be added, that is 900. Then 20,000 minus 2,000, that is 18,000 plus 900, 18,900 will be the net amount. And here, trade discount 10% and sales tax 5%. In the demarks column, we should write. Now, what we'll do? We'll add these columns. Then total of gross will be 85,000. Total of discount will be 7750. And total of sales tax will be 900. And this plus this, this minus this, plus this one, 900, equal to net amount is 78,150. Then again, I'm telling you, the students, when you will work out this sales day book, you will check your answer. How? Check your answer. That gross amount was 85,000 less trade discount was 7750. That is 77250. And 900 plus sales tax 900, therefore 78,150. This is the net amount. You can check your answer, cross checking you can do in this way, and then you can be sure that your sum is right. Thank you.